In this session, we're going to talk about decentralized identities in blockchain, and specifically attestations.
So the first question I have is, my understanding is that decentralized identity is about users having a full control over identity, its lifespan, and its sensor resistance, so no one can take it away from you.
That's right. And it's such a broad topic, right, because it touches a lot of different systems. One of the things, groups that's been driving this very heavily is the Decentralized Identity Foundation. Microsoft is a core member of that foundation, and we've published as part of that a white paper. So we would encourage you to go take a look at that. We'll include the link with this session so you can take a deeper look at that. But specifically today, we'd like to talk about attestations and what actually is an attestation. It's essentially a proof, right? So if you're doing something where you essentially say, I'm claiming that I can do this thing, or I'm claiming that I'm part of this group, or I'm claiming that I have the appropriate rights to do this thing, you need to prove it. In the real world, we use many things to do this, right? Traditionally, people would use a password. You would say, hey, I want to log on to my laptop. Well, how do I prove that it's you that's logging into that laptop? The only way is through a password or through facial recognition or something like that. So think about it in that context. Don't think about some of these internals, but the attestation is actually this claim and this proofing that shows that.
Sure. So we have a demo, so let's jump right into it.
Okay, so in the demo here, what we have on our screen is a node-based application from our partner and our friends at uPort. uPort is an application that can run on your phone, but it's also much more than that. And one of these tutorials that we're going to show here is showing off this attestation model using some real code here. We'll share the link to this code so you can run through this demo yourself. You can actually install the application on your phone, and you can do everything that we're showing here. So I already have this set up, and I did an NPM install, so we don't have to wait on that. But basically what we need to do here first is we're going to show an attestation where we create one. So that's the first step that we have to do. I'll be using my iPhone for that so that we can see this actually work. And then basically we'll show the validation. So after I have my attestation, someone will request it, simulating what an application would do in the real world. So the first step is we need to create the attestation. So we'll basically do this create credential in here. And again, this will be in the notes, so you don't have to take notes here. We'll share this with you. And you can see that our attestation creator service is now running. And you can see it generated a funny URL for us here. And we'll go ahead and jump over to that URL, see what's up there. And you can see that we basically have one of these 3D barcodes. So I'll go into my iPhone application here, and I click on this little icon at the bottom on uPort, scan that that barcode, and you'll see that I get this login mechanism. Now you notice I'm not being prompted for a password or anything like that, because essentially my keys are stored on my phone, and I'm basically creating an attestation here, so I'm going to be signing this attestation's coming through, and you see it just came through now. So basically it says, you've just signed this attestation that's been provided to me by this app that says I'm an engineer in the blockchain engineering team, and I've been enrolled for 3 years. So great, so that's an interesting thing. If we pop back over to VS Code on my machine here, you can see that we got some output here. So one of the things we got out of this was, first off, we had the encoded attestation sent to the user. So this is basically wrapping up, and if you look at the decoded version of it, you can see that it has an object here which has those elements we showed, but it's called my title. You can see the DID that's associated with that, and you can see the data that got sent over to my phone. Now, what we need to do now is show how would we use this attestation now. So now we have this thing that exists that I've signed, and basically we need to show when someone requests it from you. So basically if I, again in VS Code here, if I call another function, so basically we have another piece of code here called request credential, simulating an application requesting credential. The requester service is fired up. Obviously this would be in a production application, would just be part of the app. Again, we have a 3D barcode. I go ahead and scan that thing as well. Now, because I have that attestation on my phone, you can see that it says my title verified by DID. So basically, that is me providing that attestation. This is the actual other side of this transaction. So if I pop back into VS Code, what you'll see here is quite a bit of output because we show an encoded and decoded version of the request here. So basically, here was the request for that claim. I said that I have this title thing, this object, and this thing basically requested it. You can see here my title was verified and has a callback there to a resolver. And there's the response that I gave from my phone. So I hope you get a better sense for, I mean, I know this was a quick demo, but showing how attestations actually function in the real world in this new decentralized identity model.
Thanks, great demo.